You know, Jerry's co-stars in LightWave, and we told him in the interview that Dr. Jerry's 79 last week. That's also about the time.
All the detail of these instances allows you to get that much more into your shots. The expectations are higher from the audience. You know, here's a spaceship that Lena did, actually. It was just some gurneys surfaced on the surface. Here's some of the examples of doing foliage of an environmental type of instance. So basically, you can create an ecosystem type effect where you have a certain weight given to certain kinds and certain percentages of foliage so that you can replicate all of the complexities in the natural environment. These kinds of things were impossible to load in to the common memory before. You couldn't get this level of detail. So it's a really great advancement. Here's a shot from Iron Sky. The guys in Finland are doing this incredible work with our NCSync spaceships. So NCSync is one of the big new features that's coming to you in LightWave. I'm really proud of that. The next thing that kind of ties into that is our flocking system. Now, flocking is incredible. This is a hypervoxels flocking situation. It's kind of an abstract thing, but it kind of shows you what you do. This is an example that's more practical. A whole herd of our piranha aliens, also done by Luna here, running on the surface of a planet. How many times have you needed that? Like massive things. The Terra Nova, this is perfect for that situation. These things are being deformed by MPD, so you can apply MPD to all your instances. Here's flocking of bats. This is a bat that I actually did with no-call bats. We put it into the system, and it has intelligent flocking, so they detect each other. They don't collide. You can have them attract and repel, and you just get really quick, beautiful flocking for birds and airplanes and helicopters, any kind of thing, swarms of bees. The flocking system is incredible. It's in conjunction with our instancing system. Also, they both work with VPR. If you want to see this stuff in real quick, it's awesome. The next thing I want to talk about is Python. So Python is the foundation of scripting language, and Disney's using it. ILM, Weta, it ties all the programs together. It is the way that you can really get into the nuts and bolts. The problem in the past was that we had ELScript, which is a fantastic language, but it was its own island unto itself, much as Mel scripting is. And so Python scripting is the new language that is kind of like bringing all the packages together, allows you to communicate between the packages. And what you just saw was that that chessboard was all being driven by Python scripting. So some of our developers actually tried to play chess with this and they lost. So you can have intelligent, you know, in the scripting built in. The next thing we have are interchange tools. Interchange is so important in pipeline. All the pipeline stuff you heard talking about here from Eric and others. Our biggest one is GoZ. The new one is GoZ. So the GoZ support is a button push to get you from ZBrush directly into LightWave back. So if you start modeling and pushing, thank you. So get your models correctly in. It's awesome. It's incredible. One button push back to LightWave layout to render. It sets up all your nodal flow for you. It figures out your displacement maps automatically from ZBrush. Here's another great thing. You can send your models into ZBrush, sculpture endomorphs, more targets, and with one button push, send those back in and create your work targets for your face. That was how the face that was the real-time cut the character. So it's incredible. The technology pulls together, and it all works together. Another thing is Unity support. We're shipping with Unity now. When you get Unity, you will be able to load LightWave scenes in. You'll be able to have interactive feedback back and forth between the Unity game engine. We love our game community. We're coming full force with that. So interchange is great. In addition to the FBX support, which I think is second to none, we actually have a better FBX import and support iPhone than some of the Autodesk. So we have great, one of the things I want to mention about that is the pixel perfect camera matching between Maya and LightWave. So FBX, that was a thing in the past, it was difficult. We've nailed that, we've cracked that down. So you also have Maya geometry cache, which allows you to not only have NDD deforming, but you can load things directly from Maya back and forth into LightWave. That's what they're doing also on Terra Nova and Dinosaurs. And I mentioned the FBX pixel perfect camera matching thing. This is all tool sets that allow you to integrate LightWave with any production tool. very useful. Let's, we mentioned that before. Also, we mentioned the game development Unity engine. VFX artists like me and Al and John, we do the audience and Don, we love to blow things up. We love destruction and mayhem in our lives for some reason. So, you know, when we implemented some tools to allow you to do this, we wanted to have a complete workflow. So you're not just, you know, here's some new tool, we kind of figure out how to do it. We have a new workflow, a tool called the Crasher Tool. You load in any object into Modeler, and it decimates that object and breaks it into pieces. One of the great things about Crasher, so you want to blow up ships, you want to smash glass, you can place fracture points to control exactly the density of where you want that to happen. It's obvious, the artists need to be able to control this stuff. But the great thing that you need to know about LightWave's implementation is in other packages, I'm not going to name all of them, but pretty much every other package, the pieces that you break up are all separate items. So when you load the kind of complexity and detail that you load in these types of scenes, you have a scene graph that is too easy and you can't deal with it. So in LightWave, it can be contained in one object. Choose to. You can also break it up the other way if you want, but in LightWave, you have the choice of saving a broken pane of glass as one object. When you take it in, fracture is very useful because you place these fracture points, but where it really shines is with our bullet implementation. So we've implemented bullet in LightWave 11 so that you can load these things in. There's our bullet. Oh, that's great. Yeah, bullet's working. There you go. Well, check this out. So 2012, we're talking, you know, you want to kind of do that level of effects, we are bringing it to you, and this is some great work that was done with our fracture tool and with Bullet. Very simple to get this stuff going and interactive. This is a shot that Matt Warner, our interface designer, did in the hotel, so this is really quick. And it underscores the fact that it doesn't take you 17 hours, you got to go away and come back and see this stuff, it's interactive. That shot that you saw with all the stuff coming down was so interactive that it happens literally in front of you. Whereas if you remember dynamics calculations, not just in LightWave, but in any application, it's a big kind of pain to get through that. So it's interactive with even this tremendously large amount of data. There's many other enhancements in LightWave 11. You know, actually, you know, we can't cover them all because it would be too long, but I do want to mention a few highlights that I can report. For the kind of work that we do, enhanced render buffer support, with presets, so that you can choose your render buffer channels and save all of those out as presets for the types of shots that you want to do. This is really great for the kind of compositing workflow that we do on pretty much every shot. There's tons of render enhancements, so that you can see unified sampling. There's the print render output for any kind of print work or magazine work, and it figures out those layouts for you. It's a really great workflow. In addition, we have the shadow capture. We don't have shadow capture, we have shadow reflection. Not only does shadows, but it does reflections. If you want to match it up to your plates, it just nails it. So we want you to get your shots done as quickly as possible. This is the kind of workflow that we're implementing for our students. This is a great one. You can shift click and you select a surface automatically. So if you click on a surface, yeah, there you go. I used that the other day. It's actually really useful. So major speedups also in our OpenGL. We've had multiple time speedups in OpenGL to facilitate the kind of walkthroughs that you just saw, so we have the frame rates that you're working with. VPR now works for instancing as well, so all that instancing, you turn it on, it's gorgeously lit, it looks beautiful very quickly, and you know, the shift click surface thing, of course. But handling of large data sets has also been optimized. When we were testing with some of the geometry that we've had some of our Vegas Studio testers have sent to us, we started with scenes that had so much data, it took like 30, 45 minutes to load some of the assets. We got those down to about 3 to 4 minutes with like thousands and thousands of objects, tremendously complex data. So all of that has been sped up. Another thing I want to say is, you know, we're expecting the final release of LightWave 11 software by the end of the year. So all of the things that you've seen tonight that I just showed you are not coming, they're in the software. So our internal beta team has been testing this, it's working. Studios are using them in their shots as I'm going to show you later, so it's not like a future thing that you may get sometime far away. But if you want to wait for the final release, that's fine. If you want to get your hands on some of this stuff now, you know, we're actually offering this to all of our 10 and 10-1 registered users now. So if you want to go to the website and get our pre-release version of LightWave 11 before we ship the final, all of the things we just showed you are from that version of the software, and our studios are using that. So you can get more information on our website if you want to get more details.
The rowdy bunch.
I have to go back there.
Go up the stairs, please.
Everyone, writing me, please.